Good morning, Facebook family and friends. This is your boy, Bishop Patrick McNeil of the Cross of Christ Deliverance Temple Church of the Nazarene, welcoming you to our morning inspirations. Truly, this is the day that the Lord has made. We shall rejoice and be glad in it. I'm so glad to be amongst the land of the living. I'm so glad that God woke us up, clothed in our right mind, giving us another day to lift up his name, that he may draw all men unto himself. We do thank God for our early morning rising just as well as our late laying down on last night. Truly, God is an amazing God, and we don't want to prolong the time, but we want to get right out the way. We know you got to get to work, and we got work to do. So we're going to go before the throne of grace, asking that we may obtain mercy and find grace to help us in a time of need. Let us go to the throne of grace. Most gracious and heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank and praise you for waking us up, clothed in our right mind, giving us another day to worship your name. Truly, this is the day that the Lord has made, and we shall rejoice and be glad in it. Thank you for waking us up, giving us another opportunity, Lord God, to share in the gospel of Jesus Christ. Father, as we begin to open our hearts to receive what thus saith the Lord God Almighty on this morning, touch these your people, I ask, in the name of Jesus. Father, give your man servant the words that will speak to the hearts of man, that will turn Israel's heart back unto you. Father, I thank and praise you for every person that will be a part of this broadcast. Lord God, I thank and praise you for the earnest expectation, Lord God, to receive a word from you, Lord God, through your man servant. And Father, and as we prepare our hearts to hear from you, give us ears to hear what the Spirit has to say to the church. Cause our hearts to be receptive, to receive your word in an edifying way. Let your word sink deep down in our souls to sanctify us in these last and evil days. Father, we continue to pray for that family that lost their mother, the son and the grandmother, Lord God, according to what transpired. Father, I ask in Jesus' name that you would send your spirit to that family, Lord God. Give them the spirit of comfort as they go through this trying time. Those Asian people who lost their lives, Father, there are some families grieving on this day, this morning, Lord God. We pray that you would have your way, touch their families and their loved ones. Thank you, Lord God, for causing us to arise, shine, to give you the glory. And Father, we pray that you would just bless those that are arising out of their slumber and sleep. Give them an opportunity to take care of their business as they engage us in morning inspirations. And Father, those that are on their way to work, give them traveling mercies as they travel this early in the morning and engage us in morning inspirations. Thank you for every person that will be a part of this broadcast. We pray that you would just bless them now, touch them from the crown of their heads to the soles of their feet. Give them something that's going to strengthen them, not only for the appearance of man, but in the innermost parts of who they are, so that they may be prepared to meet with Jesus when he returns. We love you this morning. We give you glory, honor, and praise in Jesus' name. Lord, have your way. Sister Tilly, we thank God for you on this morning. Truly, this is the day that the Lord has made. So glad to have you with us. We love you so much. Pastor McNair, we love you so much. Thank God for you on this morning. Thank you for joining us in Morning Inspirations. We're not going to prolong the time. We're going to get on out the way and let God have his way. Come on, let's get into some worship. Come on. Come on, somebody on the television, turn it around.
Sometimes discouraged, but not defeated.
Come on, Pastor Barbara Berry, God bless you all this morning. We love you so much.
Not destroyed.
Tell God it's turning around. Somebody say it's turning around.
There are times I,
Sister Jennings, God bless you on this
don't
morning.
Understand,
we love you so much.
But I believe it's turning around for me. I've had struggle.
Brother Tommy, God bless you this morning, my brother. Glad to have you in the morning inspirations on this morning. God bless you, my brother.
Felt so alone. Some of my friends, they let me down. But I still believe it's turning around for me. Around for me. Around for me. Around for me. It's turning around for me.
Around for me.
Can you just say it into the atmosphere?
Around for me. Around for me.
It's turning around.
It's turning around for me.
'Cause I can see the breaking.
I can see the breaking of day.
God is
making a way. A change is coming for me.
If I stay strong.
If I stand strong and believe.
There's no reason to doubt.
There's no reason to doubt.
I know he's working.
I know he's working it out.
And it's turning around.
It's turning around for me.
This is the good news.
It won't always be like this. He will perfect that concerning me. And sooner or later, it'll turn in my favor.
Sooner or later, turn in my favor.
Turning around,
it's turning around for
somebody
me.
Say it's turning around for me. I know what it looked like on the outside.
It won't always be like this. The Lord will perfect that concerning me. And sooner or later, turn in my favor.
Just lift your hands to the atmosphere and claim your season of turnaround. Hallelujah. Now let's say this together. Come on.
Around for me.
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 Around for me. Around for me.
It's turning around. I can feel it happening.
Around for me.
Around for me.
just say that.
Sister Nitra, God bless you. We love you all this morning. Come on and give God some worship on this morning. Somebody ought to tell God, I know, Lord, I know what it looks like on the outside, but I already believe you for the inside of what you're doing in my life. Come on, somebody. Somebody tell yourself, sooner or later, I'm coming out of this. I'm coming through this. I'm going to be victorious in this, and I'm going to get the blessing after this. Watch this here. Y'all not going to praise God with me, but somebody ought to just tell God thank you, because your sooner is coming, your later is coming sooner than you think. Watch this here. Your later is coming sooner. Somebody say, my later is coming sooner than I think. Come on, somebody. Your later, y'all not going to talk to me this morning. Your later, somebody's prophesy to yourself this morning and say that my later is coming sooner than I think. Watch this here. Why? Because if you're going to be blessed, sometimes you just got to speak your blessing into existence. Are you hearing me, what I'm saying? Sometimes you just got to tell yourself that my later is coming sooner than I think. My later is coming right now. Watch this here. Sometimes you just got to tell yourself, Sister Shavonda Brown, you got to speak life to yourself, health to yourself, strength to yourself. And you got to tell yourself sometimes that my later is coming sooner than I think. Watch this here. Somebody say, my later is coming sooner than I think. Sooner or later, it's going to work. Y'all not going to talk to me this morning. Sooner or later, it's going to turn in my favor. It's coming. My turn is coming. My season is almost here. My time is almost now. My later is coming sooner than I think. Somebody shout glory if you know what I'm talking about. Somebody ought to be giving God praise. Why? Because somebody woke up to a blessing this morning. Are you listening to what I'm saying here? In this day, you're going to receive something from God that you didn't even know you were going to get. And you are going to be able to give God all the praise for the blessing that he has bestowed upon you. You got to speak into existence those things that are not as though they be. You got to tell yourself, even though I don't have it right now, my later is coming sooner than I think. Somebody say amen if you know what I'm talking about. Sometimes you just got to say that thing. It's not that you're testifying that you have it, but you're speaking into existence, a non-existence entity. Watch this here. And when you speak things according to the Spirit of God and according to the will of God, God moves on what you ask, or God moves on what you say according to your faith. Is that all right? And so you may not have it right now, but if you tell yourself, my later is coming sooner than I think, you'll find yourself being in the position to receive from God the thing that you've been praying about. Watch this here. Come on, let's get right back into worship. Come on. Come on, you got to speak that thing into existence. Come on, somebody, I'm speaking it.
Lord, if I find favor in your sight.
Come on. Lord, please.
Lord, please hear my heart's cry, 'cause I'm dead. be where you are. So I'll cross the hottest desert. I'll travel near or far. Let's say it together. For your glory. Gotta be where.
Come on, give God your worship on this morning.
One more time. Wanna be where you are. Gotta be where you are.
Come on, just give God some worship on this morning. I wanna be where you are. Come on, just tell him. I gotta be where you are. I want to be where you are. Peace is where you are. I don't claim to be a singer, but I love to worship God. Amen. And we've got to learn to just worship God sometime. Amen. Why? Because we love the hoop, holler, jump, run, and shout. We love to give God praise because we know that the cliche says, when the praises go up, the blessings come back down. We know that the Bible says that the Lord inhabits the praises of his people. But sometimes you got to be able to just stand flat-footed in one place, raise your hand, and let the Holy Spirit minister to your heart. Amen. And that's that you find in the place of worship. Amen. When you begin to worship God, you begin to just raise your hands and speak with your heart and not with your lips sometimes. Sometimes there's not a praise you can get out. There's just a place of worship that God wants to take you to. Why? Because in that place of worship is the presence of God. Are you listening to what I'm saying here? In that place of worship, Sister Williams, is the presence of God. And sometimes God wants to just minister to you in his presence. Somebody say amen. I know that it's a great thing to worship and get, praise and get crazy for God and let God know with your outward expression that you love him so much. But there comes a time in your walk with God that God is saying, now I want to minister to you, and I can't minister to you if you're constantly in a praise and you don't know how to worship. We got to learn how to worship. Now, worship is just not standing still. It's many different facets to worship. But when the worship songs are being sung, there's a time when God will want you to just stand flat-footed and begin to raise your hand as the Spirit of God ministers to your soul. Are you listening to what I'm saying here? Sometimes the expression of love has to be an inward expression and not an outward expression. Are you listening to what I'm saying here? Sometimes God wants you to show him how much you love him by just allowing him to minister to your spirit. Are you listening to what I'm saying here? Praise the Lord, Bishop Trevor. God bless you. Our own Bishop Trevor, God bless you. Sometimes God wants to just minister to your spirit. Are you listening to what I'm saying here? Sometimes God just wants you to be still and see the salvation of the Lord. And when you're moving too much or raising your voice with a joyful noise all the time, how is it if God speaks in a still small voice and you're always raising your voice with a joyful noise, you will hear this still small voice? Are you listening to what I'm saying here? Why? Because sometimes God will speak with a still small voice simply because in worship you're able to hear it. Mm-hmm. Come on, somebody. Sometimes he wants you to love him with your innermost parts and not praise him with your outermost parts. Come on, somebody. Sometimes God wants you to love him with your innermost parts. What does that mean? He wants your heart. The Bible says, render your heart and not your garment. Sometimes we wear praise like a garment. That's the only thing we do when we come to church, but we don't understand that even in church, you got to change clothes. You got to be able to go from praise to worship. Y'all not going to praise God with me up in here. You got to be able to change clothes like you change at home. Somebody say amen. You got to be able to go from praise to worship. Understand there's a difference between praise and worship. Praise is an outward expression for your love for God. Worship is an inward expression for your love toward God. Come on, somebody. Y'all not going to praise God with me. And we got to be able to change clothes. We know that the Bible says he shall give us the garment of praise for the spirit of heaviness. But there's a time that God wants to be intimate with us, and he can't get intimate when we are in a praise spirit and not a place of worship. Come on, somebody. Somebody say, I want to be intimate with God. Somebody say, I want intimacy with God. Come on, somebody. There's a time when a husband and a wife will want to spend time together, and they don't want to hear any fast songs. They want to just spend time at home listening to slow music like Luther Vandross, and that's the time they can begin to speak to each other, because there's not an outward expression of praise, but there's an inward expression of love. Somebody say amen. Y'all not going to talk to me up on this morning, but I'm going to give God some praise. Somebody say amen if you know what I'm talking about. So sometimes God requires. Sometimes God requires a still moment. When Moses was at the Red Sea, he was questioning how he was going to get past what was before him, and how he was going to get over what was before him, and how was he going to get past what was behind him. Somebody say amen. The Pharaoh was behind him. The Red Sea was before him. He was between a rock and a hard place, and so he began to question, and the Spirit of the Lord God said, be still and see my salvation. Stop questioning. Stop wondering. Stop asking yourself how you going to do it, and just watch God operate in the spirit of holiness. Somebody say, I'm watching. Somebody say, I'm watching. I'm watching God operate. Watch this here. And when he was still, watch this here. And when he was still, he began to see the power of God move like never before. He saw God's breath breathe on the water, and the water went up on both sides. even though it had fish and sharks and everything else in it, they could not touch Moses and them. Why? Because the breath of God was holding back the water. Sometimes you got to just watch God hold back everything so that you can be victorious in getting to the place he wants you to be. Huh? Come on, somebody. Sometimes you just got to say, God, hold it all back. I don't want to see none of it. I want to be still and watch you work. Somebody say amen. Somebody say, I'm watching God work in my life. Sometimes you just got to be still and see the salvation of the Lord. You can't be in everything at all the time. You can't be praising and jumping and running and hooping and hollering constantly when God sometimes speak in a still small voice. How would you hear what God is trying to say to your spirit unless you are operating now in the spirit of worship? Somebody say, I'm in the spirit of worship this morning. I'm in the spirit of worship this morning. The Bible says that David danced all out of his clothes. That doesn't constitute praise. That just means he was doing something. He could have been just simply worshiping God. Because many times when David wrote in the book of Psalms, he was not writing a praise. He was writing a love song to God. Somebody say amen. How many of y'all know that your worship is a love song to God when you learn how to worship? God's ear is inclined to our worship and our praise. Somebody say amen if you know what I'm talking about. Why? Because your worship will let God know that you for real with him. Somebody say amen if you know what I'm saying. Your worship will let God know. I heard the songwriter say, my worship is for real. Didn't say my praise. It doesn't mean that your praise is not real. It just means you're in a place of worship and you're utilizing what's inside you to allow God to minister to you. Somebody say, he ministered to me this morning. Somebody say, God is ministering to me this morning. I'm in the spirit of worship. Somebody say, I'm in the spirit of worship. So, worship is a quiet time. Many times in the Bible, we know that Jesus told the people, he said, listen, when you pray, do not pray as the hypocrites do on the street corner to be seen of men, but rather get into your closet. Go into your place of worship. Find your place of worship. Y'all not going to talk to me. Find your place of worship. Why? Because when you're in your place of worship, he that heareth in secret can reward you openly. You can't run and be around everybody simply because something is happening. Sometimes you got to withdraw yourself in order for God to minister to you in your secret place. The Bible says in Psalms 91, he that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High. If everybody has access to your anointing, you don't understand why when you leave them, you feel drained. Is because you're always in the presence of people that's drawing on your anointing. You got to get in your secret place. Somebody say, I'm secret squirrel today, baby. Somebody say, I'm acting like secret squirrel today. Listen, watch this here. You got to get in your secret place. For the Bible says, he that dwelleth in the secret place shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. Watch this here. Shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. You can't be in the presence of everybody all the time. Come on, somebody. You can't want to be in the presence of everybody all the time. Sometimes you just got to get all by yourself so that God can minister to you the thing that he wants you to know. Watch this here. When Joseph had gotten all by himself, it was the Spirit of God that came to Joseph and said, your 12 brothers will bow down to you. And he ran to the place where he would always be. And that's with his brothers. And he told them. Sometimes when God tells you something, you can't run and tell nobody or anybody or everybody. You just got to hold on to it. If he gave it to you in secret, he'll reveal it openly. Somebody say amen. For he that heareth in secret shall reward you openly. That means somebody going to know about it. Everybody going to see it if you hold on to your secret. Somebody say, I got a secret and I ain't telling nobody. Come on, somebody. Somebody say, I got a secret And I ain't telling nobody. Somebody say amen. Why? Because everybody is not going to be happy with the secret that you reveal. Some secrets you got to keep to yourself until the revelation of God comes forward in your life, through your life, and upon everybody else that's connected to your life. Somebody say amen if you know what I'm talking about. Somebody say, I got a secret and I ain't telling nobody. Come on, somebody. God will give you a secret. Somebody say, in your secret place. Watch this here. In your secret place, God can speak to you. You got to learn to be still and see what God is saying, or hear what God is saying, or see what God wants to do in you, through you, and for you. Watch this here. And so here it was in our scripture today. Here it is in our scripture today. Somebody say, I got a secret. Y'all not going to talk to me up in here. I think I'm making y'all go to sleep. But I want y'all to wake up with me this morning and get into this word, because there is a rhema word from the Lord. David understood it. Why? Because everything David tried to do, he did it in secret. Somebody say amen. And that's why when he came to the revelation that he was outside the will of God, he got into the secret place. That's why he said, he that dwelleth in the secret place, he got into the secret place of his dwelling. Watch this here. And the presence of the Lord showed up in the secret place and began to minister to his spirit. Y'all not gonna talk to me. God doesn't always want your praise as opposed to your worship. God doesn't always want you to run around the church as opposed to stand still and watch him work. Somebody say amen. God doesn't always want you to hit your head on the benches trying to get up on the bench and shout, as opposed to being still and watching God operate in the house of God. The Bible says when the disciples were in one place on one accord, that means everybody was doing the same thing at the same time. That means everybody was doing the same thing at the same time, and the Holy Ghost came in the house. Somebody say amen. When they got, now mind you, they could have been up there when they were first went up there doing their own thing. But when they came to the revelation that whatever was supposed to happen wasn't happening, and they began to get on one accord, the Bible says when they were on one accord, then came a sound as of a rushing mighty wind, and a spirit, the spirit came down as a clothing tongues, as a fire, and it made its abode on each one of them, and they were all filled with the Holy Ghost and began to speak with other tongues and prophesy. Y'all not gonna talk to me up in here. Sometimes God needs us to be quiet. Sometimes God needs you to be quiet. Somebody say, I'm being quiet. Because when you're quiet, you're listening. Somebody say amen. How many of y'all know, how many of y'all used to tell your children, if you don't be quiet? Why? Because when they were not quiet, you felt that they were not listening. If you felt like your children, when they were not quiet, weren't listening, guess what God feels when you're not quiet? Somebody say amen. Guess what God feels when you're not quiet? If you feel that when your children are not quiet, they're not listening, guess what God feels when you're not quiet? Come on, somebody. Why? Because he wants sometimes to just speak to your soul. Sometimes, praise the Lord, my brother Greg Walker, God bless you on this morning. Sometimes God wants to just speak. Somebody say, speak to my soul, speak to my heart, Lord. I need to hear your voice. Come on, somebody. We want God to incline his ear to our prayer, but we're not open to what God wants to say in us, through us, or to us. Come on, somebody. We always want God to incline. We pray, Lord, incline thine ear unto my prayer. And when God gets ready to speak, we so busy making so much noise that God is saying, I'm speaking, but you can't hear me. I'm trying to bless you, but you're not in the right place to be blessed. You all over the place trying to get a blessing in Zion. If the blessing is falling in Zion, stop going to Jerusalem and go on to Zion and get the blessing. Somebody say amen. If you know what I'm talking about, stop running from all over the place when God is saying, I'm trying to bless you, but you can't hear me. I'm trying to speak to you, but your heart is not ready. Y'all not gonna talk to me up in here. Watch this. I got to get ready to go. I'm going to share this message with you, and then I'm going. Watch this. In Psalms chapter 5, verse 1, we're going to look at Psalms chapter 5, verse 1, and I'm going to get right out the way. But watch this here. Psalms chapter 5, verse, starting from the first verse down to the 12th verse, not going to be long. I promise you, I'm going to make sure you be on time for work. Watch this here. The Bible says, watch this here. The Bible says the chief musician upon Neoloth, the Psalm of David. Watch this here. David was a musician. He was a chief musician. We look at David as the seed of Abraham, and he is. We look at David as the killer of Goliath, and he is. And we look at David as the one who tore the bear and the lion, and he did. But you got to understand that David was a skilled musician as well. You got to understand his position. David understood, I might be king, but I'm still musical. Somebody say amen. That means whatever attributes I have to glorify God, I'm going to use them for that purpose. And so the Bible says the chief musician, that means he was the baddest in the land. And when somebody had a spirit that they needed to be delivered from, David had the music and the power to play it to get that spirit off you. Come on, somebody. Y'all not going to talk to me up in here. Understand who David was. Not all music is good music, and not all music is bad music. There's some music that will soothe the savage beast. Huh. And David was a skilled musician. There's some music that when you hear it, that rage you were in when you first walked in your house began to subside, and the spirit of rage began to leave you, and you go into a spirit of praise, a spirit of worship, or a spirit of feeling good once again. Watch this here. There's some good music that is good for you, and then there's some bad music that you don't need to be listening to. If the music disrespects you in any kind of way, then believe me, it's not inspired by God. God does not inspire things that causes you hurt, harm, or pain. He doesn't inspire it. He might let it happen. They might make it, but he doesn't inspire it. And David was a skilled musician, and that is not our message on this morning, but I want to share with you the nature of who David was. We talk about all the victories that David did, but we never actually talk about what brought David to the kingdom. What brought David to the kingdom was music. Come on, somebody. What brought a lot of people to church was music. We get stuck on the music and miss the message. Y'all not gonna talk to me here. Don't let the music be the only reason why you come to the kingdom. Come on, somebody. Don't let the sound of the worship be the sound of the praise be the only reason why you come to the kingdom. When after you get to the kingdom, God requires and desires your worship. Somebody say amen. Don't let the praise be the only thing that brings you to the church. Listen, don't let that be the only reason why you came to the church. Why? Because praise may draw you in, but worship will keep you. Somebody say amen. Praise may draw you in, but worship will keep you there. Why? Because when you worship, watch this here. When you praise, the blessings come down. But when you worship, that's an inward expression for your love toward God. And when you are in that place of worship, you can watch God operate in your life. So the Bible says in Psalms chapter 5, verse 1, give ear to my words. David is saying, listen to me. I'm saying to you this morning that what I'm saying is a fact. It's not something I made up. It's not something I wrote, I had to study, write, or put it together to make it sound good. David said, listen to me. I'm saying to you, listen to what I'm telling you. Why? Because God is in the place of worship right now. Why? Because he wants to speak to the hearts of his people. He wants his people to understand. For the Bible says, in all thy getting, get an understanding. You can't get an understanding if you're praising him all the time. You sometimes got to stop and watch God operate in whatever it is that he's trying to do in your life. Is that all right? My brother Paris Lilly, My man, God bless you. God bless you. Glad to have you on with us this morning. But watch this here. Sometimes you got to stop, because when you make a lot of noise, you miss what God is saying. And many times we want to come to church, and simply because the praise is going on, we want to stay for the praise, but we miss the message. You can't miss the message simply because you came for the praise. David was a skilled harp player. He was a musician. Watch this here. He was a musician, but he understood, when I get to the kingdom, music might have got me here, but worship is going to keep me here. Y'all not going to praise God. Music might have got me here, but worship is going to keep me here. Come on, somebody. It doesn't matter what brought you to God. What matters is now that you're there, what you do in God. Somebody say amen. It doesn't matter what brought you to God. Somebody say, it doesn't matter what brought me to God. It's what I'm doing in God now that I'm here. Come on, somebody. I don't care if drugs, alcohol, sexual immorality, homosexuality, lesbianism, whatever brought you to God, it doesn't matter. It's what you do when you get here. Come on, somebody. Or what you let God do when you get here. Somebody say amen. Let me put it in that fashion. It doesn't matter what brought you to him. It's what you let him do in you while you're there. Somebody say amen. Come on, talk to me up in here this morning. Somebody shout glory if you know what I'm talking about. And so David said to the people of God, listen to me. Give ear to what I'm saying, my words, oh Lord. Listen to me. Once you come on, somebody, watch this here. David said in chapter 5 of Psalms, verse 1, consider my words, O Lord. Consider my meditation. Lord, I'm meditating on your words. See, once you get here, you got to know what to do now that you are here. Come on, somebody. Once you get here, you got to know what to do now that you are here. And once you get here, God will endow you with power, or he will bring people into your presence that will pour into your life if you're listening to what he wants to do in you. But if you're coming simply because you want the accolades of what he can provide, then you're never going to get what it is that God wants to give you simply because you have an agenda when you first came. Somebody say amen. You can't come to God with an agenda and ask him to do what he wants to do. You got to be open to whatever God decides once you get to the place where God would have you to be. So David said this. Give ear to my words, O Lord. Consider my meditations. Consider the time that I spend with you. Most of us are not actually spending time with God. We wait till 6 o'clock in the morning for morning inspirations, and that's when we get what we need. Morning inspirations is to inspire you for the rest of the week or for the rest of the day, but it's not the only thing that you need to grasp at in the morning or in the day. Watch this here. You need to still pray for yourself. You need to still trust God for yourself. You need to still walk this walk for yourself. You need to still believe God for yourself, but you can come to morning inspirations just to get a little inspiration so that you can fulfill what it is that God wants to do in your life, or you can hear a word that will push you into the greatness of the calling of God that's on your life. Watch this here. So David said, hearken unto my voice. Consider my meditation. Listen to me, God. Listen to me. Point to yourself and say, Lord, I'm speaking to you. Somebody say, Lord, I'm speaking to you. I'm asking you to hear me. Y'all not going to talk to me. When you get in the secret place, it's where God wants to speak to you. But there are times that you got to make your request known unto God. Stop running to people trying to get people to pray for you when you have the power to pray for yourself. The Bible says, make known your request unto God with prayer and supplication. It didn't say go get prayer. It said make your request known with prayer and supplication. That means you have the authority and power to pray for yourself, to believe for yourself, to get from God what it is that you desire, because your faith has moved God to answer the prayer that you have sent up before his throne. Somebody shout glory if you know what I'm talking about. Y'all not helping me this morning. Watch this. David said, I got to go. David said, give ear to my words, O Lord. Consider my meditation. Hearken unto the voice of my cry, O King, and my God. For unto thee will I pray. Only to you, God, will I pray. David said, I'm praying, God. I'm praying to you. I'm having the bishop minister the word to me, but my soul is crying out to you. See, I don't want you to ask me to pray for you all the time, because I'm going to direct you to the place where you can pray for yourself. Come on, somebody. I'm going to give you the tools that you need to go down on your own knees and speak to your own God. Somebody say amen. This is your God. All I'm here to do is give you understanding on how to properly engage the God you say is yours. If he's yours, then the same God I can get a breakthrough from is the same God you can get a breakthrough from. Come on, somebody. All you got to do is learn to speak to the God you say is yours. Somebody say, he's mine, and I'm talking to him now. Come on, somebody say, he's mine, and I'm talking to him now. What I do is give you the key. The key you got to stick in the lock of your faith and unlock your faith so that God can move on whatever it is you're praying for. Watch this. I'm not the God you need to pray to. I'm not the one you need to bring your sacrifice to, all your requests or supplications. I'm the one that will direct you to the one that you need to be praying to. Watch this here. David said it this way. Give ear to my words, O Lord. Consider my meditation. Hearken unto the voice of my cry, my King and my God. Watch this. You're mine, and I need you to hear me. Watch this here. You're mine, and I need you to hear me. Watch this here. For unto thee will I pray. Verse 3. My voice shalt thou hear in the morning. God's what people, many people say, well, Bishop, why you get up so early in the morning and preach the gospel? It's because David says, in the morning I pray to you. Why? Because when you pray to God in the morning, watch this here, that means nothing else is on your heart but what you want to do for God. When you start your day and start to pray, you start thinking about what your day is going to consist of. But when you arise, shine, and give God the glory, and you start your day with praise, worship, and the word, then you already know that there's nothing that's going to interfere with the place you're in when you arose this morning, simply because you're in your secret place, and in your secret place, nothing can reside but the presence of God. Come on, somebody, nothing can enter into my secret place but the presence of God. And so when you start your day with God, then there's nothing that can infiltrate your emotions, your mentality, or your character. Watch this here. Why? Because you're in a place that nobody else knows where you are but God. And in that place is the fullness of God's glory. And in the fullness of his glory, you can get whatsoever you ask God for. Watch this. Come on, y'all stay with me. Watch this. So David said, my voice shall thou hear in the morning, O Lord. In the morning will I direct my prayer unto thee, and I will look up. Thou art not a God that have pleasure in wickedness, neither shall evil dwell with thee. The foolish shall not stand in your sight. Thou hatest all workers of iniquity. Thou shalt destroy them that speak leasing. The Lord will abhor the bloody and deceitful man. But as for me, I will come into thy house in the multitude of thy mercy. He said, listen, as for me, I know what you hate. I know what you don't like. Six things the Lord hates, and the seventh one is an abomination. David said, I know what you hate, but as for me. Come on, somebody say, as for me. Come on, you're not going to write that. Somebody say, ask for, I know what God don't like. I know what I must be doing. I know what I ought to be doing. And I know what I'm doing right now. But I will praise God. I will pray. I will get up early in the morning and direct my praise, my worship, and my prayer unto you, O Lord, in the morning, simply because you will incline your ear, simply because my praise in the morning, my worship in the morning, the word in the morning is rich until my day start. Come on, somebody. And then I got to start thinking about the rest of the day. But I don't want to think about the rest of the day until my day start with the morning inspiration. Morning inspirations. It's got to start with prayer. It's got to start with the word. And it's got to start with praise and worship. Why? Because when you do that, then you don't allow things that happen in the day to infiltrate your place of worship. Somebody say, as for me. Praise God, Sister Tilly. Somebody say, as for me. David is saying, as for me. Listen, David is saying, as for me. Watch this here. David is saying, as for me. Excuse me. David is saying, as for me. As for me. Watch this here. Verse 6. Verse 5. The foolish shall not stand in thy sight. Thou hatest all workers of iniquity. Thou shalt destroy them that speak leasing. The Lord will abhor the bloody and the deceitful men. Verse 7. But as for me, I will come into thy house in the multitude of thy mercy, and in the fear will I worship. David said, and in fear will I worship. Not the fear that can send me to hell, but the fear that lets me to know that the beginning of wisdom is the fear of the Lord. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom, not fearing what he can do to you, but just fearing who he is because he's God. Watch this here. David said, In my fear will I worship. He didn't say praise. He didn't say get crazy. He didn't say dance all over the house. He said, I'm going to stand flat-footed in the presence of God and let the power of God and the Spirit of God minister to me. Somebody say, watch this. Verse 8, lead me, O Lord, in thy righteousness. Because of mine enemies, make thy way straight before my face, for there is no faithfulness in their mouth. Their inward parts is very wicked. Their throat is an open sepulcher. They flatter with their tongue. Destroy them, O God. Let them fall by their own counsel. Cast them out in the multitude of their transgressions, for they have rebelled against thee. But let all those that put their trust in thee rejoice. Let everybody that's trusting you rejoice. I know the enemy of your destiny has been chasing you all week long, all day long, all morning long. But when you arose this morning and put your feet on the floor, the enemy of your destiny got mad because you woke up. Come on, somebody. The enemy of your destiny got mad because you opened your eyes and got even angrier because you put your feet on the floor. So if he got angrier because you put your feet on the floor, he turned the furnace 7 times hotter because now you're in your place of worship and you're in your place of praise, and he cannot infiltrate the place where you are because light has no fellowship with darkness and the presence of the Lord is revealed in your secret place. Somebody say, I'm hiding. Come on, somebody say, I'm hiding. Y'all not gonna talk to me. Somebody say, you hide? Yes, I'm hiding. Why? Because in my secret place, you can't come. So you can't influence me to do things that are against what I believe simply because you can't even enter the place in which I am. All of us need to walk around in our secret place. Why? Because we got people who will come to us trying to infiltrate our space by bringing negative influence into our presence. And sometimes you just got to stay in your secret place. Why? Because you know what you would do if you would step out of there. But you got to stay in your secret place so the Spirit of the Lord God will protect you from everything that's trying to destroy you. Watch what he says. Watch what he says. Watch what he says. Verse 11, but let all those that put their trust, let everybody that put their trust. Somebody say, let everybody that put their trust. The Bible says in Proverbs chapter 3, verse 5, it says, trust in the Lord, 5 and 6, Trust in the Lord with all thine heart and lean not on to your own understanding, but in all thy ways acknowledge him and he shall direct, he shall lead you. Come on, somebody. I need God to order my steps in the Lord. You need God to order your steps in the Lord. You need God's presence to lead you in the path of righteousness. David said, yea, though I walk. He didn't say I wasn't going to go through something. He was saying, when I get to the place of going through, I'm going to walk in with the presence of God upon me, in me, so that when I get into the place where I'm going through something, my behavior, my attitude, my character won't change from what God has made it, simply because the obstacles that are in my way is bringing some kind of dissatisfaction in my life. David said, I'm about to go through. In Psalms 23, he said, I'm about to go through. Yea, though I walk, I'm getting ready to go through this. And that's what people fail to realize. You can't always ask God to deliver you from something. Sometimes you got to ask God, Lord, be with me while I'm going through what I'm going through. Why? Because if he's with you, you're guaranteed to be a victor over whatever it is that you're about to face. David said, yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Lord, I'm taking you into whatever I'm about to go through because I know that inside of it, you're going to supply everything I need for me to be able to get through it. And when I come out of it, I will be a victory. I will have the victory over it. What you talking about, preacher? I should be happy about going through something? You sure should, especially when you got God on your side. I need you. That's right, brother Lily. God bless you. I need God to guide. Somebody say, guide me. Guide me, oh Lord. Be my lamp. Be that lamp unto my feet, that light unto my path. Watch this. See, I got to close with this. I got to get ready to get on out of here. I got 3 minutes. Can I have those 3 minutes? Watch this. The Bible says, but let all those that put their trust in you, let them ever shout for joy because thou defend them. If you gonna shout, shout because he's your shield and your buckler. Come on, somebody. Why? Because the Bible says when the enemy shall come in like a flood, the Spirit of God will lift up a standard against him, and you can decree and declare that no weapon that is formed against you shall prosper, and every tongue that rise up against you shall be condemned, for this is the inheritance of the children of the Lord. David said, you are my shield. Watch this here. He said, I rejoice. I have joy. Why? Because you defend me. Somebody say amen. If you are to rejoice and have joy and praise God, praise him because he is your shield and buckler, but worship him because he's your savior and God. Huh. Come on, somebody. Y'all not going to talk to me up here. Praise him because he's your shield and buckler, but worship him because he's your savior and God. Huh. Watch this. Let them, verse 11, but all those that put their trust in thee rejoice. Let them ever shout for joy because thou defend them. Let them also that love thy name rejoice in thee. Verse 12, final verse. For thou, Lord, wilt bless the righteous with favor. Come on, somebody. Somebody say, thou shalt bless the righteous with favor. Sooner or later, it's going to turn in your favor. Somebody say, my later is coming sooner than I think. The Bible says in verse 12, for thou, Lord, will bless the righteous with favor. Just look up to the Lord and say, my later is coming sooner than I think. Because sooner or later, it will turn in your favor. He said, David, in Psalms chapter 5, verse 12, for the Lord will bless the righteous with favor. Wilt thou compass him as a shield? He's my shield and my buckler. And I know that if I hold on to God's unchanging hand, sooner or later, it will turn in my favor. Somebody say, my later is coming sooner than I think. We do thank God for his message on this morning, the songs of praise and worship. We thank God for everybody that was connected to the message on this morning. I pray that this message has blessed your heart. I pray that it sink deep down in our souls to sanctify us in these last and evil days. I pray that you were encouraged and your faith has increased. Just lift your hand and say, Lord, sooner or later, I'm going to hold on to your unchanging hand because I understand that sooner or later, it will turn in my favor. Come on, somebody. Somebody say, sooner or later, it will turn. That means whatever I'm going through is working for my good. All things work together for the good, for them that love God and for them that are called according to his purpose. Listen, sooner or later, it's going to turn in your favor. You may not have it right now, but it's coming. Somebody say it's coming. I may not have the blessing right now, but it's on the way. Watch this here. It may not be my season today, but sooner or later, it's going to turn in my favor. Because it's turning around for me. Point to yourself and say, it's turning. Sister Starks, point to yourself and say, it's turning around for me. Somebody say, all things. I like that. All things work together for the good. That's right. Listen, sooner or later, it's going to turn in my favor because it's turning around for me. Watch this here. David said, verse 12, for thou, Lord, will bless the righteous. With favor wilt thou compass him with a shield. He's going to turn that thing. He's going to shift. Somebody say shift. When you shift something, you move it from one place to the next. And when God shifts the atmosphere, he moves you from one place to the next place, out of the place of drought into the place of plenty. Somebody say amen. Somebody say, I'm waiting for my place of plenty. But while I'm waiting for my place of plenty, I'm going to stay in the secret place of the Most High. Watch this here. Why? Because I need God to speak to me, and I'm not going to make a sound until I hear the voice of God tell me when to shout. And when he tells me when to shout, I know soon my later has come sooner than I thought, because God is going to turn it around for me sooner or later. Come on, somebody say, sooner or later, it's going to turn in my favor. All things work together for the good, for them that love God, for them that are called according to his purpose. Sooner or later, God is going to shift the atmosphere in your favor. Some of y'all already had your atmosphere shifted. Let me tell you something. When God, the government didn't provide a subsidy for you, God provided for the government to be able to give to you, because what the government set up destroyed some of y'all foundation from having a job or even being able to take care of yourself. And so God raised up somebody who would give you what it is you need to be self-sustaining for a moment. But don't squander the blessings of the Lord simply because you want to go back to the way things were. They will never be the way they were. So be wise as the serpent and yet harmless as the dove, and understand that just because the indignation is being lifted, God is turning it around for us. He's shifting the atmosphere. He's going to cause the blessings of God to rain on your life. But be wise and be a good steward over the little things, and watch the increase of God come on you and overtake you. Be courageous, but be wise. Be courageous, but be wise. Use wisdom with everything you do and say, simply because your season is coming back and God is shifting your atmosphere. It's going to work in your favor because he gave it to you. Somebody say, he gave me favor this morning. Somebody say, he gave me favor this. Y'all, I want everybody on my line to write, he gave me favor this morning. I want to see everybody write, he gave me favor this morning. Watch this. I want to see you write it. Come on, y'all write, he gave me favor this morning. I want everybody on this live to write, he gave me favor this morning. I want to see it go down the line. He gave me favor this morning. Sooner or later, it's going to turn in my favor. Somebody wrote, right, he gave me favor this morning. Amen. Praise the Lord, sister. Tell her he blessed you with favor. Amen. He gave me favor this morning. I got favor this morning. Somebody say, I got favor. He gave me favor. I want everybody to write it. If you are on this live, say, he gave me favor. Tell God what he gave you. Say, he gave me favor. It's working. All things are working for my good. Come on, somebody. Somebody say, all things are working for my good. Come on, somebody. Come on, somebody say, he gave me favor this morning. Y'all not gonna talk to me up in here. Somebody desired it, wasn't able to grasp it, but you got it, and now it's yours. So tell God this morning, sooner or later, it's going to turn in my favor. He gave you favor, and you need to tell him thank you. He gave you favor, and you need to tell him thank you. Listen, if you woke up clothed in your right mind and God gave you another opportunity to tell him thank you, you ought to tell God thank you simply because the favor of God was on your life last night and God decided that you were worthy enough to wake up, to get a second chance, to breathe the breath of life into your nostrils so you may arise, shine, and give God the glory. You ought to tell God thank you simply because the favor of God is on your life and you have another opportunity to worship God in the beauty of holiness. And this too shall pass. Everything that you're going through that tried to block you, hinder you, stop you, cause obstacles to get in your way, God is saying, I'm removing everything simply because it's your season and I'm turning it around. I'm shifting the atmosphere. I'm going to operate in you so that whatever you're going through can move out of your life and you can find the favor of God operating in your spirit. Sooner or later, somebody say, my later is coming sooner than I thought. Somebody say, man, I know what we've been through over the last year. Somebody say, I know what we've been through over the last year, but today I got to go. I know I'm past 7 minutes past my time, but give me 3 more minutes. I'm only going to go 10 minutes past. Watch this here. It's working in your favor. Somebody say, God is operating in me to find favor with him. Not only will you have favor with God, but you will have favor with God and man. That means if God got something for you, he will use man to give it to you. The Bible says the wealth of the wicked is laid up for the just. What does that mean? That means the enemy of your destiny, if you live right, gonna have to bless you. Somebody, y'all not gonna talk to me up in here. The enemy of your destiny, if you live holy, gotta bless you. Watch this here. He gonna cause people that don't like you to come and put money in your hand. Somebody that don't care for you is going to come and bless you. Watch this here. Y'all not going to praise God with me. Sometime God will take the wicked people in your life and use them to be the blessing that he wants to give you. Somebody say, even my enemies going to bless me. Even those that don't care for me going to give me something. Watch this here. My hope is in nothing less than Jesus Christ and righteousness. Somebody say amen if you know what I'm talking about. I'm not coming out the secret place to get blessed. God going to bring the enemy of my destiny to the door of my secret place so that the enemy of my destiny can bless me, but yet I still don't have to come out to receive it because whatever I need is in the will of God. Somebody say amen if you know what I'm talking about. Whatever I need is in the will of God. And so we thank God for his blessings on this morning. He gave me favor. Somebody say, he gave me favor. My enemies is going to bless me. Somebody say, your enemies is going to bless you. And so we thank God for you joining us on this this morning. Amen. We thank God for everybody that was a part of this live. Amen. We pray that this word blessed your soul. Pray that you got what you needed this morning to go forward throughout this day. Join us tomorrow at 4 o'clock for our new converts class. This is the weekend. Come on, somebody. This is the weekend. There's a time where God will allow us an opportunity to wind down from the week that we had before. But this is the weekend. This is the time where we could take a moment and begin to focus on us as we allow God to minister to us throughout the rest of this weekend before the week starts again. Take a moment out of every day and just tell God how much you love him. Amen. And love somebody who can't love themselves, or pray for somebody who don't know what prayer can do. Why? Because if you have the tools necessary to show somebody that they can get the breakthrough that you got, or the breakthrough that they need, then share with them the gospel of Jesus Christ or how you got your breakthrough. Somebody needs to know that the same God that did it for you can do it for them. Be encouraged. We say here at the Cross of Christ, as we depart from this time, we pray that your day be as blessed as your morning. Be encouraged. Love somebody. Pray for somebody. But most of all, encourage somebody in Jesus' name. God bless you and enjoy the rest of your day. I'm Bishop Patrick McNair of the Cross of Christ Deliverance Temple Church of the Nazarene, thanking you for joining us for Morning Inspirations. We'll see you tomorrow, 4 o'clock, new converts class. We have it on Zoom. We don't do it live simply because it's a class and people say things that are private, and we don't want to put people's private business all out there in the atmosphere or on social media. We love you so much. God bless you. And have a great day. Bye-bye.